online, on digital, and on 88 to 91 FM. The Radio 2 Art Show with Claudia Winkleman.
She's so misguided, it's all so one-sided. That dim-witted girl dares to tangle with me. She's prissy, she's clueless, and I want her shoeless. I'll show her how fiendishly mean I can be. I want those shoes to establish just who's number one, from the east to the west. Then I'll be complete with the world at my feet. And red always suited me best. I know I hold sway over all I survey, but I now need a much bigger deal. The shoes are the key to the making of me, so find her and bring her to heel. When I get that footwear from her and it's put where it could have been, should have been, right from the start, my power will grow, it will blossom and flow through the world, through the years, and straight to my heart. We all like to dance, so now here's your chance. You'll dance till your very last gasp. Gyrate, pirouette, you'll swelter and sweat and stumble right into my grasp. You'll find you can't stop as you dance till you drop and stumble right into my grasp. Enjoy your dance, my pretties. And now, you, my monkeys, my darlings, yes, it is time at long last for you to do your work. Off you go and mop up the mess. I want that little girl and her mangy little dog. But most of all, I want my slippers! Now go, fly, fly, fly! You're welcome, my pretty. Ta-da!
Quite scared now. Because the person who sang that is standing opposite me. Welcome back to the Radio 2 Art Show. Still to come, we meet Giles Hargreaves, dog Douglas, the star of his latest book for children. But first, we've just heard Red Shoes Blues performed by my next guest, Olivier nominee Hannah Waddingham. It's one of the new songs featured in Andrew Lloyd Webber's much-talked-about musical adaptation of The Wizard of Oz, in which Hannah plays the Wicked Witch of the West. Hannah, welcome to the Radio 2 Art Show.
Hi.
No, don't do that, because I really am quite... I was so scared of The Wicked Witch when I was little, the fact that I'm now sitting opposite you. I'm so delighted you're not green.
I couldn't look less witchy poo in real life, though.
No, you're beautiful and blonde, and you don't have an enormous chin.
No.
And you're not green. But that's the best part. I mean, I hope the other cast members aren't listening, but that really... that would be a fair...
Well, I mean, that's why I took it. It was a no-brainer.
Was it? When you got the call, yeah, you were just like, course, yeah, where do you want me?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And when they said, you know, we're going to put a song in for her and...
And she's now a bigger part, isn't
yes.
she? But also, I have to say, and again, I really hope the lion and the other people aren't listening, but in the film, she was the thing that you took with you. You know, her stripy tights,
yeah,
her
I
green...
Yeah, I don't know. Oh, no. She doesn't have stripy tights. That's my sister, the Wicked Witch of the East.
Oh, of course, the Wicked Witch of the West.
Oh, get it right, Claudia.
Okay, do you not have
Wicked
a stripy tight?
Wicked Witch of the West, she's much worse than her sister.
Do you have a stripy tight?
No, I don't.
Oh, you
I
green?
Have a sassy, sexy, lacy tight underneath all my kit and caboodle.
Is it quite a daunting task, especially the days that you have to do two performances, to yes. be that evil and to be that...
Well, I actually try and get a bit of a balance because I'm very aware that there are very young kiddies there. So
yes.
the way I look, if you see how I look, if people go on our Wizard of Oz website, the way I look is frightening in itself. And because my heels are 4 inches, I'm 5'11", and then my hair, which is actually pointy hair rather than a hat.
Yes.
Rob Jones, the designer, did this extraordinary
That's
design.
Brilliant.
I'm actually 7'2".
Oh, so really, you could just come out and make cupcakes.
Exactly, I could come out and just stand there and be scary. So I actually decided to just make it very clear what I'm after, which is the slippers, and to add humour to it so that the children... So that I confuse them completely and they
yeah.
think, well, why do I like her a little bit as well?
Yeah, it's part of me.
And I don't
to
want them to
great.
Just cry and run off.
No, that would be unfair.
Although sometimes at the end of the show, when the kids kind of run to the front of the stage and are waving and smiling at the curtain call, they naff off back to their parents when I come out.
Do they? And you're going, I'll just come
and
out
I
for
think,
another bow.
Oh, my work here is done.
Yes, they are sobbing. Talk to me about, because obviously there's so much attention about it, such a beloved film. Were you absolutely terrified? Press night, describe me, you're 7 foot, you have hair.
Well, actually, for the first time ever, you know, as you get more established,
yeah.
it is more daunting on a press night because you know that the press are thinking, right, come on then.
Yeah.
What's she going to do in this one?
Yeah.
And your reputation precedes you, hopefully. But with this one, because I have got a prosthetic nose, big old witchy chin with a wart, painted green, I also play Miss Gulch at the beginning, you know, the old hag on the bike.
Yeah.
I'm so deeply disguised that I just kind of sat inside it all
yes.
and thought, I don't know what everyone's worried about. I was absolutely fine on press.
Were you? That's hilarious. I love that. You're wearing a proper
yeah.
mask.
Oh, completely.
Are you delighted with the reviews? You have been singled out.
I don't read them, so I don't want to know anything.
Oh, right. Yeah, well, okay. Well, yeah, you haven't been singled out. I mean, okay, I'm not saying anything.
I've heard
you'd
they're
be
nice.
Delighted.
I've heard
scared.
They're nice. My dad's hilarious, rings me and says, I know you're not going to read it, but well done.
Yeah, and you go, okay, fine.
Because you really do have to take the rough with the smooth. And if you start reading things and thinking, oh, are they complimenting me? Are they complimenting me? And then you'll suddenly read something that's hideous. That is the only thing that you take with you, trust
yeah.
me.
Yeah, yeah, of course. And also, yes, just better not to know. Let's talk about Danielle Hope, who, of
yeah.
course, got the role for as Dorothy
yeah.
through the TV show.
Yeah.
Did you think, be honest, quietly to yourself before you met her and saw her sing, like, oh, yeah, whatever?
Do you know what? I actually, if I'm perfectly honest, I don't mind saying this, I don't really like these reality programmes. I've said it to the powers that be, and I understand why they do them, because it's great for the show and great for ticket sales, and actually is bringing theatre back and glamorising it again,
yeah.
like it is on Broadway. When I was out on Broadway, it's a sense of occasion, and it's become that again here. And I think it's a lot to do with the fact that these reality shows have brought it to the masses on television, and so people are coming to the theatre more. So if from that angle, it's great.
Yes.
But in terms of, I know plenty of fabulous girls who've come up through the ranks and really worked hard and don't get a shot. So I'm a bit torn
yes.
between the two things. But in terms of Danielle and Sophie Evans, who's our alternate, who was the runner-up,
yeah.
they are both 18 and are the most gorgeous, gorgeous, down-to-earth, lovely, hard-working actresses more than reality stars.
Yeah,
they
are
both
they?
Want to be actresses. And it's very evident. They take the work, and from day one in rehearsals, they absolutely made it all about the work.
Probably quite hard for them in a way,
yeah,
for Danielle,
oh,
because she's coming in with Olivier nominated. You know,
yeah,
there's
yeah.
Michael Crawford.
Absolutely.
There is the best of the best.
Yeah.
And she's got to somehow go,
she's
I'm
the
proper.
Star of the show, and we all have to give it to her and put the spotlight on her. And she takes it and runs with it. And thankfully, there's not a bratty bone in each of these girls' bodies.
Isn't that fantastic?
They've totally taken it. When I first heard Danielle sing Over the Rainbow, bearing in mind how many times she would have sung it already on the programme.
Yeah.
Totally making it fresh and looking at it, as I always like to do with songs, looking at it as a sung monologue. and making sense of it.
Yes.
And just telling her story. She's really, they really are charming, charming girls.
What are the new songs like? Because, of course, there'll be the classics. This is for anybody who hasn't seen it, going, oh, but will they still sing? And they, you know,
everything's in there.
Everything's in there. But new, like your song.
New songs, yeah. Well, Danielle and Sophie, as the Dorothys, they have a new song at the beginning called Nobody Understands Me, which is in Kansas.
Oh.
Which is great, very kind of acoustic, rhythmic song at the beginning.
Yeah.
And then we go into Professor Marvel, obviously played by the Crawf, as I like to call him.
Is that
Michael
what you
Crawford.
Call him?
Oh, yeah.
What's he like?
Gorgeous.
Is he?
Gorgeous. And I actually have a little bit kind of starstruck moments with him
sometimes. Yeah, of course, I would.
I'm holding his hand at the curtain call at the London Palladium.
Ring a ding
ding. Doing anyway.
Yes. Who's taking a photograph? Oh, yeah. Not allowed.
But so there's his song, which is called The Wonders of the World, and it basically sets up everything for Dorothy. It's like subliminal placement for Dorothy, all the little things that she then sees in Munchkinland. So it's brilliant Tim Wright and Andrew have written it. It just...
I love that.
Whether you realise... Yeah, exactly. So there's that one. And then, of course, in Act Two, there's my song, which they've called The Red Shoes Blues.
Like
I think it should have been called You're Welcome, My Pretty, but there we are.
Yeah.
Slight bone.
Never mind. Let it go. Hopefully Andrew's doing something else at this time.
Yes, exactly.
And hasn't heard.
The thing that's great, though, is that all these new songs, and I'm not just saying it to big up the show, all these songs, you will wonder why they weren't in the film in the first place.
Oh, will you?
And that's a real...
That's a testament to how brilliant they are. They just absolutely fit.
Yeah, totally fit.
Can we talk about the green for a minute?
Yes.
Just girl to girl.
Yes.
How? I mean, look, I paint myself bright orange, so I get it. I've never done green. I imagine at the beginning, so excited, I'm green.
When they first did it, I was like, oh, this is brilliant. Showing all my friends.
Yeah.
Sending a picture on my phone.
Yeah, sending pictures, do it,
now,
putting it up.
Now I'm taking pictures of myself without the green, with spots, and sending them to a dermatologist.
How much do you hate it? How do you get it off? That's a genuine question.
With very, very beautiful, expensive products and a hot muslin cloth.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Yeah, so I know you know what I mean. Yeah.
Love it!
But, thankfully, because it does look so great...
Yeah.
Once I'm green, I just think, yes, to be fair, it does look fabulous, and I wouldn't have it any other way. But because I have a prosthetic nose and chin and they're made of foam, we can't use aquacolour like the other Wizardy Witchy musical. So we have to use silicone airbrush. So it takes 8 minutes to spray on and 45 minutes to take off.
19 days to take off. Why don't you just keep it on?
I know.
Genuinely.
Stand in a cupboard. Because I can't, because on a two-show day, I then have to de-green to be Miss Gulch again.
Of course.
For a scene that's 1 minute and 15 seconds.
Oh, my God. I don't even know what to say. I don't even know, but I love Miss Gulch.
Oh, I actually prefer playing her because she's the real person.
Yeah.
You know, she's the germ. The Wicked Witch comes from.
Brilliant word, germ.
Yes.
That's exactly right. Yes, she's properly... Thank you so much for coming in. I want to mention Macmillan Cancer Care.
Yes, they've just asked me to be one of the faces of their campaign, which is, I have to say, doing a job, a high-profile job like this, that side of it is by far the best side of it for me. And I got involved because... two of my closest friends are recovering from cancer, thankfully, and Macmillan helped them. And so when they came up to me at the Olivier's and said, would you be a face? I was absolutely...
Where do you want me?
Yeah.
Green or normal?
Yeah.
I bet you...
Because I didn't realise one in three people will be...
Affected.
Yeah, diagnosed with cancer.
Diagnosed.
Yeah. And there's 2 million people who suffer from cancer at the moment. Yeah.
Staying with charity for a moment, but returning to Wizard of Oz and charity, aren't you doing a special performance in aid of Comet Relief?
We are.
That's going to be fabulous.
I'm not sure how I'm going to get my red nose over my green nose.
I don't know how that works. Maybe you could just
hold it. Give it a go.
Yeah, put it on top of the hair.
Oh, no, I'm going to ram it on there. Come on.
Yeah. Come on, water.
Or I'll stick it on the damn dog. Ooh,
yes.
I say damn.
Too late.
I just did.
Yeah. Never mind. Thank you so much for
coming
in.
You're welcome. It's lovely to meet you.
Andrew Lloyd Webber's Wizard of Oz is at the London Palladium, starring Hannah Waddingham, and it's booking until September.
Yeah, but it's so going to go on longer than that. Yeah. I mean, we're packed.
Yeah, you're never leaving.
That doesn't mean there aren't tickets.
Yeah. No, exactly. Still try. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.